is Alan Ashton. Welcome to Lyme Bay. We're here this weekend for a festival of organ music. Join us with over 300 people to see what's on offer here.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's a bit of a walk from me. Now we've got some serious bits where I introduce you to the producer. Are you ready for this? The producer of the weekend. Would you please play us a great friend of mine?
Valentine's night, and I hope you are with your sweetheart, or if not, someone else's sweetheart. Now, I'm just to prove it's Valentine's night, you're quite right. Okay? Now then, apart from giving you all a big welcome, nice to see you all, I want to mention that the effort this weekend is not my effort, it's a team effort. Many thanks to all my team, they appear in the programme, you'll see them throughout the weekend. So anyway, I hope you will enjoy yourselves. After saying that, it's back to you, Andy. I leave all the other announcements to you. So carry on with the walk. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to how are we?
One of the biggest developments has been the Worldwide Organ Facts site, and to tell us a little bit about it, here are the people who started it. Alan?
Hello. It started, I guess, with my wife Margaret here having done a website for the keyboard club that she and I started many years ago. And Tom, our third member of the team over here, suggested, well, why don't you widen your horizons a little and do something for the whole of the organ scene in the UK? And that's how Organ Facts was born. Tom collects the data, lists of concerts and clubs and so on. Margaret is our expert, in fact. She's the one
who... I get to do the fun bits.
She does all the designs. And it keeps us very busy. But we've had tremendous fun with it and terrific feedback. It's obviously popular because more and more people are going on the internet these days, even the so-called silver surfers. So we hope it's of some value to the organ and keyboard world.
And can you actually tell from your site how many hits, I think they call them, that you've actually experienced since you started the site?
I can answer that one, yes. We're getting average 2,000 pages a day, which is not bad for a 3-year-old wrinkly since.
How do you see it in the future? Have you got any sort of special things that you can tell us about that you think you might try?
Yes, I would love to have streaming audio, and I would like to have pictures. Streaming pictures, but it's the licenses that are really the killer, but we're working on that one.
And for the novice, just explain what streaming audio is.
It's so that instead of just having static pictures and print, you can actually hear the music and see moving pictures as well. But expense is holding us back, but as I say, we're working on it.
Perhaps if there's any manufacturers watching this, they'd consider sponsorship. It's the licence fee is the difficult one.
But at the moment, we've got over 80 clubs with their own individual websites now, which is something.
So what exactly is Organ Facts, Alan?
I suppose in its basic form, it's a directory. It lists concerts, it lists what's going on in the organ scene. But of course, it's much more than that. We put on news of what is happening in the UK, but there are links to other organ-related sites. It's in a way quite a fun place to go, not just for information, but
300 pages.
Yes, there are, as Margaret says, 300 pages of information. It does list the concerts for the month and the following month. It has a message board that individuals can access and put their own questions or answers to people's questions. There's also classified advertisements, again free. Anybody can just put their advertisement on there for the whole world to see. And incidentally, we do get people in the States, for example, putting an organ for sale. One was a Majestic Lowry, Florida area, Buyer Collects. We've also had major pipe organ installations from churches offered for sale on the Organ Facts classified ads. So it's become popular not just in the UK, but it's used worldwide, which is very satisfying.
Talents from playing or dancing to teach sessions
Tonight he opens the weekend with a concert spot. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please put your hands together for the very special talent of Mr. Daniel Watt.
Good evening. I'm just worried how much that's going to cost me for a nice introduction like that. It usually calls me wrong. Anyway, here we go.
To the festivals, do you think?
Well, I think it's the friendly atmosphere, and because everybody keeps coming back, you meet the same people, you make friends with people all over the country, and it's just wonderful value for money. And well, I say we just thoroughly enjoy meeting everybody every year, and it's just like one big happy family.
How many years have you actually been coming here?
12 years. 12 years. Yes.
A change in style from the organists over the years?
It's lovely to see the new ones coming on, and of course the old faces as well. And we meet a lot of them anyway through the club and that clubs and that sort of thing, you know. And I don't think you can beat something like this, as it's such wonderful value for money, and you're looked after so well, and everybody's so friendly.
And of course, this is the first time down here at Lyme Bay, and what's your opinion of this place?
Oh, wonderful. Yes, oh yes, wonderful. We've been to several, and this really is very, very good. Absolutely excellent.
What about your organ club members? Are there a lot of people support your own club and then come to these festivals, or how does it work?
There are quite a few that do come to them. Yes, I think we've got about 8 of our club here at the moment, but this one being a new venture, I think now more and more will come, now that, you know, it's for us it's easy to get to.
Right.
And it is such a wonderful, it's a wonderful place.
You sound to me as though you'll be an ambassador for the club, you'll go back and tell them everything.
Oh, definitely. Oh yes, definitely. Yes, as I say, we love it, and it's everybody so friendly.
Young gentleman, as I said, known him for a long, long time, and he plays the configuration of an organ on keyboards. So that means he's got 2 keyboards set up, and also pedals. Right? So he plays bass pedals as well. So, ladies and gentlemen, a very, very talented young man, very, very talented. Would you please hand it over to Mr. Ian Griffin?
Thank you.
held together with black sticky tape. Let's hope they've all together. And the fire students are just behind in case anything goes wrong. Anyway, that little song was a song that was made popular by a guy called Tony Christie. And it was a theme music from a program called The Protectors. Right, so I'm going now and do a little selection of songs. Starting off with a song which is one of my favourites, National Fact. A little song made popular by many people, including the original person, which was Mr. Buddy Holly. A little song called True Love Waves. After that, little medley that will follow after that song. Here we go, True Love Waves.
Peter, I suppose it's fairly true to say that you're kind of a newcomer to the festival scene, am I right?
Yes, when I compare the length of time that I've been coming to the length of time that these festivals have been organised, it's a very short time indeed. My first festival was at Barton Hall in 2001, and I came to the second one last year, and this is my third, and I shall still carry on coming.
I was going to say, you seem as though you're hooked.
Oh yes, definitely.
What about your interest in the organs? I mean, although you've only been coming to festivals for a comparatively short time, have you had a longer interest in the electronic organ?
Yes. When I went to college, because I became a teacher, I had to do a thesis. And a local dance band in the village where I used to live in Cornwall had a clavier line, which was this little three-octave monophonic keyboard with all these little instrument switches on the front of it. And I was interested in electronics in those days, and I decided that, well, I'd like to have something like that. And then a magazine of the time, the old Practical Wireless, had a design. So I got all the bits together and started building it. And when I went to college, I used it as my thesis, in the electronic production of music, physics in the electronic production of music, and I've been hooked ever since. And that was a little three-octave monophonic keyboard, which I've still got, using old things called valves, or what the Americans would call tubes. And it was probably another, nearly 10 years before I did anything in the organ world. And that was a retailer in Truro had a whole series of new Hammonds in, I think it was the M series, and they were offering courses of 10 weeks, I forget how much the cost was, but it was minimal in those days. So I did a 10-week course on the Hammond, and I was really hooked. Then after that, I had the opportunity to buy a Lowry, which was expensive, even though it was second-hand, and this was late 60s, which I had for many years, and that had 48 valves in it, and I could do some repairs on that when that went wrong, until I got to the stage where I couldn't repair it any longer, and I had to go with it the set of Creative Organist books. And I used to get halfway through book three and give up every time. I did that for years and years and years. And then my interest was rekindled about 7 years ago when I had the opportunity to buy a much better organ, still an American and a Conn organ. When my wife saw it, she said, "What a monstrosity." However, it was a beautiful instrument and with a true Leslie speaker, and I was quite pleased with that instrument. But then I started having lessons on a Yamaha with all these beautiful orchestral effects, which I hadn't come across before on a personal basis. So I was then looking around for another type of organ with these orchestral effects. And I went to a music shop in Bristol with a certain budget figure in mind, and then I looked at other things above my budget, and I went above my budget and I bought a Technics GA3 with all these lovely orchestral effects. And this was just prior actually to the first festival that I attended in 2001, and the organ duly arrived. Then the next festival, a year later, the same firm was there with the upgrade from the GA3 to the G100, and I fell for that one. And that's my present organ, and very often I'm playing at 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning.
It's just returned from very successful tours of Turkey and Sweden. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please put your hands together for Mr. Andrew Nix?
Torquay and Swindon.
And of course, at the end of every one of the night's concerts, there's always something for the dancers amongst it.
That's right. I provide for dancing because very often one of the partners come along because they're interested, but the other part is not. So we provide dancing and also other quizzes and things like that, so that the partner is also involved in the activity.
And are the dancing sessions led by professional people?
Yes, at this particular event we've got Elaine and Ted Kirby, and they are known as international dancing leaders. They got more letters after their name than letters in the alphabet, I think. They're very, very qualified, and they come along and they go on the floor first of all, and everybody else follow. Yes, they're very good, actually. Ted and Elaine Kirby, yeah.
Put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. Lovely. It was your birthday, really, not long ago. How many happy returns? Looking younger every day. You're beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together. Ted and Elaine Kirby. Now, we do want you to get up and dance nice and romantically and sexy. Halloween. They're Halloween, isn't it? There's a lot more. Oh, have you got live music as well, ladies and gentlemen? Supply the music as well. Mr. Daniel Watt.
Make it sing. But for now, let's get the big opener in with a little number called down now. Change my mind. A bit of my prerogative. Here we go. Right, sit down, please.
Collection of organ concerts years ago was going to demonstrations in hotels where the salesman got you up onto the stage and made you play Spanish Eyes in about 5 minutes flat. But it's come on a long way since then, and to tell us a little bit about it, here's Alan.
Hello Alan. This is a brand new instrument designed from Casio Electronics, one of the largest international companies which is into school education, always been into school education instruments and everything else, and this is where it helps people who come on these holidays. The person who's never played before can now play instantly within a few minutes. Instead of just your Spanish Eyes, they're encouraged to play by a light system. We've designed a keyboard like this, which is a standard 61 note keyboard which can be used for all types of playing, for the man who can play, the lady who can play. But for the other partner, we can now use it singly. There's 100 tunes here on the actual instrument. We can choose them, whichever tune we want. I've just chosen a very simple one, it's a very short one. And we put it on step one. On the screen, it tells you what finger numbers and where the notes are, and it all comes with a music tuition book. And you heard the little Japanese lady there in a Japanese accent say one, meaning finger one on the note. Three. If you, the doorbell goes, you want to answer the door or the telephone or anything else, or you're lost, the key waits for you until you're ready to play the actual note. Then it works through a system of 1 to 3, and when you got to number less than 3, that's jumping the whole system in right to the very end, you get all the accompaniment, but the lights now will not wait. That will teach you how to play and give you the encouragement to actually want to actually play. And the education system now is to get these instruments into school to try and stop some of the children just playing the game gears on the televisions and the computers, but actually get them into actual physical music. There are other instruments in the range which then connect straight to the internet, to the modems, to go up onto the websites, to collect sounds down, to collect songs down and to record them into instruments and to train you how to play them. To get children, to get them interested into music, and then hopefully we'll have a future generation of musicians.
Well, your company apparently got quite a scoop a few weeks ago, didn't they? You got yourselves onto BBC TV.
We have indeed. And that is a brand new instrument taken from this instrument into a large piano, which does full piano training. And it's all graduated weighted keys, all the keys are weighted just like a normal acoustic piano. It's passed all by the actual boards of music, especially the London College of Music. And should we have a wander over and have a look at that instrument?
Yeah, let's have a look. But firstly, just how much would this instrument cost?
£170, £169.99.
A bargain.
A bargain.
Well, Alan, this is the famous Tomorrow's World instrument, isn't it?
It is indeed.
Tell us a little bit about it. How does it differ from the one we've just seen?
This is a traditional piano. When I say traditional piano, because all the key work is exactly the same weighting as a normal acoustic, upright or grand piano. Every key is weighted, so it becomes the exact weighting of a normal acoustic piano. So you get the feel, you get everything except the looks of the old piano.
And could you actually alter those weightings?
We can for children indeed. You can alter it through the computer to make it a lightweight, so children can play the instrument. And of course then the accomplished player can come down and sit down and play or do a concert on one.
All right, let's hear a little bit of what its capabilities are.
As you notice there, we had a very light system. As we went through onto the keyboard from there, this has been developed from that. But this one gives you all of instruments of the orchestra. It gives you layer facilities. You can layer one on top of the other one, sound-wise, to make it sound like a band or whatever you want to do with it. You can also use rhythms. But the ideal being, for the children or for the person who doesn't play, you've got training facilities of all those songs. We can go into a music menu. That one's propped up there as Jingle Bells. We could use that. We can go on to average level. We can choose which lesson we want, left or right hands. We can choose which step we want. Here again, we have a nice screen which tells us what finger and also which fingers to play. And you've also got the voice prompt. Cathedral bells. It does indeed.
But that's the easy way of doing things, Alan, but from there you're obviously going to have to want to go on and learn to play scales and do all the hard work. So how does it help you in that respect?
Well, it does exactly the same. We've got the majority on here of all songs which have been done live. You've got the Sinatras, you've got the Moonlight Sinatras, Fur Elise, they're all on here. But better than that, because of the old-fashioned days when we all had to learn scales and everything out, and children nowadays want it all done instantly, we can choose all the scales to be shown how to play them with fingering. And we've just got this on the right hand. Hands together, left hand separately, or everything else.
So far, we've heard piano sounds, but are there any other kind of sound in there as well?
Well, for the home enthusiast, we've got all the organ sounds. And of course, for the person who can play, we can just do that and take out the lights. But we've got all organ sounds. We just use these as headers, and we scroll through there, we can church organ. And band, we've got trumpets, we've got string sounds, we've got choirs, guitars. And of course we've got every type of guitar. And of course we come down to this side of the instrument and we've got all our rhythms. Again, header sounds, we can actually put them in there, go through the song banking, and we've got all different sounds of rhythms. We can have it on single finger chord, which we obviously show us how to play our chords at a later stage through the light system, or we can play it with finger chord or full range chord. So we can use it as a traditional keyboard, except we have a full 88 keys which are all weighted, or to the actual piano. So it's like three instruments all in one for the home.
Well, Alan, it's certainly an instrument with lots of features on it, so let's have a fully featured finale.
Thank you. then I'm right in thinking that you probably hold the badge for being the person who's been to more festivals than most people in a lifetime. Am I right?
Yes, I think you may be, because we've known our promoter for this festival, Cled Griffith, since 20 years. And before then, he ran two or three more, which, for one reason or another, mainly the entertainment people on the site that objected to someone new coming into the music business. But having said that, it's been well worthwhile. It's been a way of life for both of us.
And do you find also that there is this nice club atmosphere?
Oh,
you
yes.
get to know people?
Oh, yes, very much so. First of all, the commitment in the first place, but well rewarded. It's like coming back to family. You meet so many nice people at all different levels of music, whether they play or listen, and this is the interesting part about it, of course.
And do you play the organ yourself?
No, but I've been involved with music for a great number of years.
I take it you were an organ club official, committee
yes,
person?
Yes, I was secretary for the East Lancs Organ Society for 4 years. I was roped in by Eric Lord, the cinema organist.
Bless him.
Yes. And then, of course, when I came to Bournemouth in 75, I'm looking for a club, which we found, of course. Very small club, struggling. But eventually an excellent committee that we got together and worked together, and we built it up to one of the biggest in the country of 300 members.
And this particular venue, it's the first time for everybody. What's your actual, do you like it here?
Yes, it has a lot of facilities that appeal, and of course the gathering as usual, the same faces.
And without sort of taking anything away from anybody, have you got a particular favourite organist that you like to hit?
No, I like them all. I've worked with most of them and watched them grow up. So, having been involved even from Bournemouth 27 years.
And does your husband play the organ
yes,
as well?
Yes, and thoroughly enjoys it.
Well, Helen, thank you very much for giving your time.
Oh, that's lovely. It's my pleasure too.
about half an hour's time, we'll be starting in the tavern bar with Ian Griffin and myself through till the wee early hours of the morning. We've got dancing in here in a few minutes' time with Richard Bauer, and we want to see, because it's still Valentine's weekend. Hope you're still feeling romantic, yes? Yeah? But if you're not going to dance, we want to see you in the tavern bar. You've got about half an hour before we actually start there, so we've got to have a dance first. You join us in there. A bit of fun and frolics through till the wee early hours of the morning. If you want to get up and sing along in there, that's what you're able to do. It's free and easy through in the tavern bar. See you through there. Bye!
Any organ enthusiast will tell you, first pipeless electronic organ, of course, was the Hammond. But we've come a long way with technology, and here to tell us about some of the modern day instruments is Phil from Versa UK.
Thanks very much, Alan. Yes, indeed, you're quite right, these instruments really have moved on a long way. We have state-of-the-art technology on Wersey, and basically we work on a Windows operating system, which means we can give you infinite updates for years and years to come. But we'll start off with that wonderful Hammond sound that everybody knows and loves. So that's one of the sounds we have, the traditional Hammond. We, of course, can have any sound at all that you can imagine on this instrument. For example, everybody loves those wonderful, wonderful theatre organs. And on this range of instruments, we can play Akai samples, which will give you any sound you like. In this case, some wonderful Barton theatre organs. From a small keyboard.
Talking of great sounds, Phil, the old cinema organ in its time, that had a lot of effects on it, and they've not been forgotten on the modern day organ either, have they?
No, you're quite right, Alan. We have the traditional drums and cymbals, just like we used to have on the old theatre organs. But of course, we've brought it back up to date with modern samples, and we can have even choirs. And all sorts of modern and innovative effects.
Your company, Phil, has just recently pulled off, I suppose you could call it a scoop. You've got yourselves into black.
That's quite right, Alan. Yes, it was a major development for us. We were very pleased when we heard that Blackpool Tower were looking for a new instrument to complement their Wurlitzer. And we were fortunate enough to go along there, along with various other manufacturers, show our products, and we've actually put a state-of-the-art £32,000 three-manual organ into the tower, which represents a big development for them for the future, and a nice liaison for us. And we're very pleased to be a part of that. And it works on exactly the same technology and exactly the same layout as I'm showing you here today.
We're talking about futuristic developments, Phil, and computer technology that these organs are built on. What's all this little screen do?
Yeah, that's a great talking point, actually, Alan. On here, we can access anything to do with the instrument. We can easily access sound. So if I just press some buttons and show you some different screens, everything's readily available here, all at the touch of a button. And we can also, with this modern technology, constantly upgrade. We're not stuck with an instrument as we used to be in the old days. So it's a completely new concept, and everything is loaded via the CD-ROM down the air. We send discs to customers. They can load them in very easily following prompts on the screen. And currently, there are various updates available, and most of them are free. And we can actually then keep the instrument current with a 10-year development plan on this.
So it's fair to say then that the organ is never going to be outdated.
It's certainly true to say in the next 10 years, yeah, with this Windows technology, we are now able to offer the very latest features for the foreseeable future.
Well, Phil, it's a fantastic instrument. Let's see what it can really do.
My pleasure, Alan.
I'm looking round. I don't think there's anyone here that ain't seen me. Am I right or wrong? Who ain't seen me? Just one. Okay. Right. Well, as Andrew said last night, I am known as the organ abuser, and I've had my problems over the years. Well, the organ I've always used, this organ is HX1. I've been playing this organ for 12 years, and the actual model of the organ is 17. Well, the one that I've been playing for 12 years, unfortunately, it really has got a bit beyond repair now, you know. I went to Eastbourne last week, and I did actually add no C, no D, no E, no C, no A, and no A. They're all the notes that are missing, and I won't so bothered about these ones down here, but this one was a problem because I do use it a lot, and Andrew was actually my A man for that night. That's why I was talking about it last night. So I've now got another HX1. This is, I think, about the seventh one that I bought, and I've never played this one before, so they all feel different. So it feels quite good at the moment. So does it sound all right? That's all right. Now's the volume, all right? That's wonderful as well. Okay. Right, I just got a little bit of a strip on the jack. You don't mind if I do a little strip, do you? Okay, right. I started off with a Trish Trash Polka. As always, I've been telling you how long it runs for. There's nothing worse than sitting there and you don't like it, so I'll be telling you exactly to the second or to the minute how long each one takes. Trish Trash, 2.5 minutes. The next one, I'm going to do a Latin medley now. This one, I normally do a slow one to get my fingers ready for the Latin, but I'm going to go straight in with it. So we have four. First one, you don't know the first one, Ellis Moore. You don't know that, do you? See? The second one is Amor, Amor, everyone knows that. The third one, Sam Burita, James Last Composition, and you don't know that one either. And the fourth one is Cavaquinho, and you do know that, so it's two you do and two you don't. I do hope you enjoy all four, and let's get on with it, here we go.
Thank you.
organiser, Mr. Ted Crippin. I've got strict instructions from Ian, my co-producer, to keep this short. So a word of thanks, a word of my thanks to my team, and a word of thanks to you for being such a great audience. So for my team and myself, good night, safe journey home. And back now to the final... now you're the surprise.
I think we really got to thank Claire and his team for an absolutely fabulous weekend once again. Thank you.